everyone, let's start with new phylum recall zoology with me. Okay, so in the previous video we have done the first or largest phylum in kingdom Animalia, that is Arthropoda, means the animals with jointed legs. Now we are going to check the main features of the second largest phylum, that is phylum Mollusca. So what are they? Let's talk here. So what are phylum Mollusca is there? As I told just now, it is the second largest phylum after the Arthropoda. We could call it as soft bodied animals also, because major examples are included here are octopus, snail, squid. All these animals are soft bodied animals. So we could call molluscans as the soft bodied animals. So here I have written as usual, they are triploblastic animals having bilateral symmetry. They have organ system level of organization, and actually they are cytocoelomate. If you compare, we know three cytocoelomic phyla, Annelida, Arthropoda and the Mollusca. These are the three cytocoelomic phyla. Annelida and Arthropoda, both of them, they show segmented body pattern. But here, molluscans don't show any segments over their body. So we could say, what are molluscans are there? These are the unsegmented cytocoelomates. Okay. So now we are going to check the main features. So as I told you, they belongs to the second largest phylum, soft bodied animals they are. Habitat, where do they stay? Some are terrestrial and some of them are aquatic, you could say. Aquatic, staying both in marine and in the fresh water. Okay, their body is getting covered by specialized covering. Now you have seen the snail. The body of snail is getting covered by a calcareous, it's made up of calcium carbonate. A shell will be there, external shell will be there. Then what are their bodies there? It is getting divided into three main parts. So what are these three parts? The first one is head, second one is muscular foot, and the third one is visceral hump. What your head is there, imagine the snail, you will understand what your head is there of the snail. It is having two tentacles over the head, which are the sensory structures. Then next one is a muscular foot, which is helping for the locomotion. And the third one is visceral hump. What exactly is visceral hump? Visceral hump is nothing but the visceral mass also, you could call it as. And it contains all the internal organs inside it. Whatever this visceral hump is there, it is getting covered by one spongy soft layer. That spongy and soft layer, you could call it as mantle. One cavity is there in between the mantle layer and the hump. Mantle layer, just now I told you, whatever visceral hump is there, visceral hump is nothing but mass of internal organs. Whatever this visceral hump is there, it is getting covered by one spongy and soft layer. That layer is known as mantle layer. There is a little space present in between the mantle layer and the hump. That space, we have to call it as mantle cavity. This cavity is very important because in this cavity only feather-like specialized gills are there. And we know gills will be helping for definitely exchange of gases. But these gills are helping for one additional function, that is excretion also. The feather-like gills in the molluscans who are present in the mantle cavity, they are helping for respiration as well as helping for the excretion process. Please remember that. Then coming to the systems. You could say digestive system is definitely it is complete with one special thing inside their mouth, that is file like rasping organ is there. Rasping organ, rasping terminology is like grating, simply crushing down the food material, in that way you could understand. So in the buccal cavity or in the mouth of this molluscans, you will be getting a specialized rasping organ known as radula. Then both circulatory and respiratory systems are present. Respiration definitely by the gills, as I told you earlier. Then coming to the next point, that is reproduction. Usually they are dioecious, means they are unisexual. In the sense, male and female are totally different from each other. They are oviparous and development happening is indirect. So here finally the examples of Mollusca. So here totally 8 examples are given in your book. So one short form I made here, it will be definitely helping you in the exam for remembering the examples perfectly. So see, the short form is, please load science pics. I'm asking someone that please load the scientific or some science related pictures. Okay, like that something is there. So whatever I have written in the black color, okay, on those you have to concentrate. So the simple one line you could remember, please load science pics. Okay, so what is that? So please, so P will come here, load entirely will come here, then from the science S and P and C. Okay, so what are they? Phyla, that is the apple snail. Loligo is the squid. Octopus, devilfish. Octopus, devilfish. It is not a fish. It is a molluscan. Aplysia is sea hare. D for dentalium. Dentalium, dentist. In that way, please remember. Because what the tusk shells are there? Really, what the shell is there? It look like the tusk of the elephant. Means tooth of the elephant. So, dentalium, tusk shell. Sepia is cuttlefish. So, you could say octopus and sepia. They are like something fish. So, octopus, October, September, like that you could remember. September, October, like fishes only. So, octopus, devilfish, and sepia is a cuttlefish. Then you will be getting the pink tada, easy to remember, because it is a pearl forming oyster. And the Cheetopleura is the example, which is also known as cheeton. So easily, CHCH you could manage and you could remember this example. So I think, like I hope, this trick will be making you very easy memorization of the all total 8 examples. So octopus, sepia, devilfish, cuttlefish. So very easily leftover examples you could do. Loligo is only little different, you could say, that is a squid. So I hope with this trick the mollusca become very easy. Okay, so continue, we will continue. I will see you again in the next video. Bye. Thank you everyone for supporting me and my channel. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel, and please write a comment in the comment box below. Thank you.